So joining me now, Professor Cornel West. Professor, good evening. Thanks
so
much
for joining.
How
you doing, my dear brother?
I'm doing okay, you know, as well as can be expected under the circumstances.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. I know what you mean.
This trial, it's gut-wrenching. I mean, Sarah summed it up there. You know, the man begging for his life, pleading to be seen as a man, like all the rest of us. From the video of George Floyd dying over and over and over again, what is this trial saying about us as a country, especially when it comes to how we all see race?
No, it takes us to the most fundamental question that has always sat at the center of not just America, but the 400 years that you and my ancestors have been here, which is, do we have the will to stay in contact with the rich humanity of Black people, to stay in contact with the beauty of Black people, the intelligence of Black people, the tenderness of Black people, the soulfulness of Black people? When you talk about Brother George Perry Floyd Jr., you're talking about a human being. You're talking about a precious son of George Perry Sr. and precious Larsenia Jones Floyd. You're talking about what it means actually to open yourself to get beyond the stereotypes and acknowledge that for the first nearly 100 years, America failed on that question. It didn't stay in contact with the humanity of Black people. You enslaved us. You exploited us. You tortured us. We tried to barbarize us, and we responded with making your democracy better, with more love, more freedom, and more wounded healing. Then we came back for another 100 years of neo-slavery. We failed on that again. Looked like under Martin and Fannie Lou Hamer and others, we were making a breakthrough. Looked like under Brother Barack Obama, we're making some progress. Here comes the backlash again. So here we are in 2020, saying very much how you started your show, my brother. Do we have what it takes to really acknowledge the rich humanity of Black folk, to treat us fairly, to treat us like human beings? Because if not, you're going to lose your democracy. Mm. You're going under. You're going fascist. If it wasn't for Black voters, especially Black women voters, you would have gone fascist under the gangster named Trump. And keep in mind, though, and this is the good news now, because this is Easter week. You know, it was tomorrow they put my sweet Jesus on the cross. Roman Empire put him on the cross for going into that temple and running out those money changers. And that temple was a huge place, hundreds of troops. But what we heard from my vanilla sister, Courtney, was what? I stayed in contact with the rich humanity of Brother George. I knew he was a tender man. I knew he was a soulful man. I knew he was a kind man. I knew he was a human being, faults and foibles, like all of us, no matter what color or gender or sexual orientation. But thank God we've got some acknowledgement mm-hmm. of it. Will the police be able to do it?
Okay.
Because I'm telling you, brother, if the police can't do it, then, you know, we're going to do it ourselves.
Okay.
I can tell you this, too. Now, let me just add this one thing, though, brother.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
I thought about Brother George, and I thought about my brother, and I thought about my father, and I thought about my grandfather. I'm not going to stand there for no 9 minutes and 29 seconds and watch somebody murder my father. No. Martin Luther King Jr. talked about pacifism, and I believe in nonviolence, but I'm not going to watch that kind of murder. I love my brother Charles McMillan. That's why he was crying. That's what his tears were about. He felt helpless. We're not going to do that. Some of us Black folk, some of us Black men, we're not going to stand there. We're going to have to intervene in some way. They ain't going to kill us like that, and we remain spectators. Because somewhere I read, silence is not an option. I don't stand with the silence. That's the last two sentences of your letter to Drew, your letter to your nephew. But America needs to understand that too. We got a self-respect. We got a self-defense. And we intervene when you start killing us like that.
I'm sorry.
We intervene out of love, brother. Out of deep love. Do it for mommy.
Let me ask you this. Because everyone I saw on that video, and I asked this earlier, everyone I saw had some empathy, saw the humanity, felt the humanity, George Floyd, as you said, foibles and all. We're not thinking that when someone's laying on the on the pavement in that situation, like what they've done wrong. We're thinking about when you're taking the life from a human being. Why is it that every single, and when you said the police thing, everybody saw his humanity and felt it, except for the police officers who were there?
Because they've been getting away with it for decade after decade after decade. Even the good policemen, in the language of the mainstream, they remain silent. And they allow the gangsters in their ranks who've been mistreating folk. And keep in mind, you know, brother, it's not just black folk who've been treated like this. You got some white brothers and sisters being treated like this, but we get 3 times. We get 36% of all of them. We're only 12.8% of the population. You see what I mean? So we're concerned about everybody. We ain't just, because we're not confined to just the chocolate side, but I'll be damned if we're not going to start with the chocolate side of town, with our blacks, our brown and indigenous folk, and our Asians. And it is in the name of love, but love sometimes can get real tough. Love is protect, respect, and correct. And we're not going to stand there and just be victims. No, no, no. Mm-mm. No, that's not Shiloh Baptist Church. That's not the West family. That's not Glenn Elder, brother. That's not Curtis Mayfield. That's not Gladys Knight and the Pips. We come out swinging.
You know, I went to Shiloh.
If it ain't got that swing, he wasn't just talking about notes.
You know, I went to Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church as a kid. That was my church
growing up. Oh, well, you know, I'm Shiloh Baptist.
And you just called it out. Professor, I'm going to do like I do with my family members and the people I know. Let me let you go because I got to deal with some things. And you're making me cry here on the TV, and I got to compose myself. Thank you. I love you, brother. I appreciate it.
I love you, though, brother. You stay strong. Indeed.
Thank you. I'll see you soon. Be well. You know, it is hard to hear the testimony about the last moments of George Floyd's life, second by second. And if you're having trouble dealing with it, speak up and ask for help. We've got some resources up on the screen right now for you. And again, don't hesitate to get help. There it is on the screen. We'll leave it up for a second, and we will be right back.